today is, what is Amazon Luna and how is it going to disappoint us all?
Cloud gaming, it's going to be so exciting. I was excited when Google Stadia announced this new 4K service. You're going to be playing on your controller, on your TV, all devices, the ads, everything they promised was so incredible. I bought Founders Edition for Google Stadia, and then I plugged it in, and then it didn't work. I was playing at about 10 frames per second on Destiny 2 with a 700 megabytes download internet connection wired into my Chromecast Ultra, and it played like hot garbage. And then I realized that cloud-based gaming services aren't necessarily quite as exciting as we had all hoped. But guess what? It doesn't matter if Google Stadia didn't work out. Your boy Jeff Bezos with Amazon, he has got Luna.
If we scroll down here, one of the cool things that's different, though, is the game libraries. You don't have to, like, buy all of these games. So this would be a good way if you don't have a huge budget as a gamer to acquire some games. And they've started with an initial deal with Ubisoft. So if you buy Luna for $5.99 a month, you would get to play, I assumedly, most Ubisoft titles for free with that subscription through this service. That would be kind of a cool deal. I mean, what do you guys think here?
I think, yeah, I actually like that a little bit. I would have liked to have seen Stadia have tried that. Not that it would have made any difference whatsoever, but that concept of being able to work with a publisher or a developer exclusively kind of, I don't know. It's a different touch. It's kind of a neat touch, I think. I don't think it's going to work, but it's neat.
Yeah, I don't think it's going to work either, but it's better than the offering that Stadia had. So what I like about this service is that you don't have to pay $9.99 a month. It's only $5.99. And they aren't promising 4K games right out the gate because they know they can't deliver that. So as you can see, they're going to test out this Ubisoft package, right? You subscribe to the Ubisoft package. Ubisoft is going to offer some number of games, probably not all of their games, but some number of games as a part of this service. So is this epic gamer that we see in the video right here an actual market that truly exists? Is there the gamer that wants to play all these games, also has a killer internet connection, and can't afford an Xbox, a PlayStation 5, and an insane PC that is also wanting this? It seems like a crazy niche market that only the most athletic and good-looking women gamers who play on CRT monitors at the bowling alley are going to be interested in. I understand the concept of having a world where gaming is everywhere, and this marketing material is trying to show that. These companies, I think, are really early. I think something like Luna is like 10 years early. We're not ready technologically for that, and these companies don't realize that. They're arrogant, they're egotistical, and they think they can pull this shit off out of nowhere without developing any new technology at all to facilitate it. Bezos needs to drop like $1 trillion in internet infrastructure around the world to make this concept work. It's just ridiculous, in my opinion. And in 10 years from now, we'll look back at the predecessors of the successful platforms of the future, and we'll say, remember when Amazon tried this and Google tried this and it didn't work out? Well, now it's working out because technology has caught up. Amazon, this is going to go bankrupt. Google Stadia is going to go bankrupt. And anyone that tries to do a standalone cloud gaming service is going to go bankrupt. The only ones that are actually going to work are ones that are an add-on service on top of the existing ones, such as xCloud, being added on top of Xbox Game Pass, on top of your PC, on top of your Xbox itself, as a way to enhance the existing gaming ecosystem and existing experience, rather than being the entire experience.
Immediately when you guys posted this topic to me this morning, I laughed. I think my response was like a facepalm emoji, because why would you copy a failed strategy from a different, you know, mega company? So Google did this, Stadia clearly a failure. This is just so that Amazon is getting more monthly revenue from users for providing more services. It doesn't matter if it's good. It doesn't need to be good. It just pads the package. It just makes the package more valuable, so you are willing to pay monthly dollars to Amazon, to Jeff Bezos, to get more of your gaming fix. At least trying to push the envelope of gaming technology forward. Maybe it's too early, but at least they're pushing.